Hey guys, thought I'd show you a little bit what we got going on today. I'm cutting the receiver groove in the top of a block. You can see it's been decked, bored, honed. It's a filled block. See the well, you see the yellows, a little bit of clay I use so the cement doesn't go all the way to the deck. So I can mill it after it's filled. So yeah, I'm gonna run through the process here. I've got my this is the plate that bolts to the deck. Up here easily real quick. This is a BHJ O-ring tool. This is the 4G plate. We had to clearance it for the front motor mount so we could do on car stuff. So that's what that's about. But anyway, this sits on the deck, gets tightened down, and then we basically check to make sure the plate is flush to the deck surface. And then we cut the O-ring groove, or the receiver groove, mind you, with this. This bolts to the top of the plate like so. Now you see the four bolts in here. It'll work its way into that and go in there and cut the groove. I'm going to get this plate squared up and measure depth and get it as square to the deck as I can real quick. I'll kind of run through that real fast and then we'll start cutting grooves. This plate is on here in square. What I was doing with the indicator, it sits, you drop the indicator in these slots and set it on the surface here and measure to the deck. That allows me to tell how square this plate is to the top of the deck surface. Obviously, the cutter, its tool itself, sits on this plate, so it's imperative that this is square to the deck, otherwise your O-rings are gonna, or your receiver grooves in this case, are gonna be not square to the cylinder, right? So then you're gonna have an inconsistent receiver groove compared to the cylinder head. So you can kind of see some marks probably on top of this plate. Every time I use it, I basically easily run over the bottom surface of it with a file and the top with a file, just to make sure the thing didn't get like dinged or anything weird as it's been sitting around for, you know, this thing sits for a couple months at a time between uses. So now that I have this thing square on each, you know, all three measurements on each hole through the whole, all four cylinders here, the next thing we do is I've already got the diameter of the receiver groove set on the cutter. So the next thing we do is zero the cutter and start cutting grooves. Okay, now we have receiver grooves cut in the deck. Give you guys an idea. They get a little close there in the center and they're close to the bore, but you're pretty limited on space. As you can see, this is a 60 thousandths wide cutter here, so on the receiver groove end. Give you another little idea. This is what the bottom of the plate is. The cool thing about the BHJ fixture is that it uses the dowel holes in the block to locate it. So you pull the dowels out of the block, stick them in the cylinder head, and then three of these holes you'll see are open, these three, for the block side, and then three of these holes are threaded for the cylinder head side. So you take it off the block, you bolt it to the cylinder head, it indexes on the dowel pins, so you know that your O-ring receiver groove in the deck and your O-ring in the cylinder head are gonna be as close to perfectly lined up as they possibly can, because everything is centered on those dowels, which gives you, you know, you want, obviously want the O-ring to be in the center of the receiver groove, so when it pushes the copper gasket in, it pushes it into the corners of the receiver groove, and that's what really gives it its holding strength. So the other thing too, I've seen some guys run the O-ring groove, the receiver groove in the cylinder head, and the O-ring in the deck. We run O-ring in the deck on MLS gaskets, but on a copper gasket like this, if you lose a head gasket with the O-ring in the block and the receiver groove in the head, it rounds the corners of the receiver groove and the cylinder head side if you did it that way, and then that edge is never sharp again. So it's very easy to have the gasket fail after one failure, whereas if you do it like this where the receiver groove's on the block side, that edge doesn't normally go away. It stays pretty, stays there. If you have a gasket failure, you won't hurt the edge unless you know, it's catastrophic and it torches part of the block, obviously. But from what we've seen, if we have a mild lifted head, then you can just typically replace the gasket and you're okay because that edge is still sharp. So that's pretty much it for the receiver groove side of things.